The Echo Show 15 is finally getting some more use. Amazon has just released an update where you can activate Fire TV on your device for free. Now, in this video today, we're gonna take a look at what that actually means, what functionality is currently available, and can you control it with a remote? We'll be taking a look at that in today's video, so stay tuned. Hey everybody, welcome back to another video. So I woke up this morning to view on my Echo Show 15 a new update, and it said Echo Show 15 meet Fire TV. So yes, I can now watch Fire TV content on my Echo Show 15, which I was super excited about. We were teased this update when Amazon had their big fall announcement, and it is finally here. So obviously I went and I did the update. It took about 15 minutes, had a couple reboots, but now I wanted to show you guys what the experience is like and what the good and the bad is of this update. Okay, so I triggered the software update. It was pretty easy to do. It downloaded and installed the new software, and then it popped up and asked me to configure the Fire TV. I then went ahead and clicked on Get Started, and it brought me up to select my favorite apps. These are apps that it's going to pre-install onto the Fire TV stick for me. I selected a handful of the apps, clicked on Next, and then it asked me to pair a remote. Now, there are a few different options here with the remote. You can either pair a remote. It says that it is only capable with the Fire TV remote third generation. Now, if you want to buy the third generation, there is a discount for people who do have an Echo Show 15. You could purchase it through the Echo Show 15 and get a $20 discount. So you're picking up the remote for $10. If you don't want to do that, you can use a virtual remote that will display on the screen, and you can also use voice prompts. You can just ask for things, different shows and things like that. Okay, so here is the Echo Show 15 display that I have set up. We've got a new button right here for Fire TV. And if I scroll down from the top, we've got another button right here for Fire TV. So I'm gonna click on that and we're going to load it up. So here's the Fire TV right here. If you've ever used one of these before, you're probably pretty familiar with it. This one does have a touchscreen capability, so you can go through, view different shows, launch different things right here. I'm gonna go ahead and tap on Netflix. We'll get that launched right here, but here is where it gets a little bit different. The touchscreen feature goes away. You can't use that anymore. The only way is you're gonna have to use the virtual right here, which you can see we can click on the up and down to go through the different profiles and select stuff right there. Now, let's go ahead and scroll back up. I'm gonna select on my profile right here, and then I'm gonna click on, we'll go ahead and click on this show right here and take a look at it just to give you guys an idea. I gotta say, the quality of the video was much better than I was expecting from this device right here. I mean, typically when I use it, as far as like going through the different menus and everything like that, I don't think it's all that great, but viewing this on here, I was very surprised on how good the actual video quality was on here. Now, if you want to bring up the virtual remote, there is a little button right down here. You can tap on that, bring up the virtual remote, or close it. But I have my remote right here. Now, I did set up and install the Fire TV Pro remote. This is their brand new remote. Now, I will say that it doesn't say that this one is supported, but I was able to connect this just fine, and it seems like everything is supported for the most part. I wouldn't be surprised if some of the features on here didn't work, and that's why it doesn't specify it, but let's go ahead and, I mean, I can click here and pause it. If I go down here and clicked on one of the fast buttons, let's go ahead and click on Prime Video. It's gonna launch Prime Video up for us. Everything should, you know, is gonna be working just fine. I can go through here and, you know, I've got all the functions that I would out of just a normal Fire TV. Now, a few other things to mention with this device right here is that they also updated the spatial audio. So they tweaked the speakers on here to make them sound better. And the speakers sound great on here. I would say that, you know, it feels like I'm watching kind of like a normal TV. Now, what you're gonna do is let's go ahead and I'm gonna scroll down here. If you want to add more apps or view your apps, you can click on this right here. I can view installed apps. I can see apps that are an option right here. So these are all the ones I have installed. But I can go to the app library and load up more apps or different things like that. Or for example, let's say I don't have Disney Plus on here. So I can say, Alexa, Disney Plus.
Here's Disney Plus.
Okay, and now it brings it up for me and asks me if I want to download it. So I can go there and automatically download it, get everything set up, and then I would log in with my account to get it all done. So pretty easy to do. You can either voice activate it, you can use the remote that it comes with. It's got the virtual remote on there. And then you can just go through, like I said, just with a normal Fire TV stick and just launch and watch everything that you would typically want to on here. Now, depending on where you have this device and how you have it set up, there are a bunch of different mounts that you can actually get with this thing. I saw one that actually had an under cabinet mount, which I thought was pretty cool. Pulled down from the top and it looked like you can actually swivel the Echo Show 15 on there. So if you have it in the kitchen, a different area, and you want to swivel that around like an actual TV, you can do that too. There's another one where it's got a stand that just sits on the counter too, also has a swivel. Lots of different options that you can do and set up to configure this the way that you want to. Okay, so what do you guys think of the new features with the Echo Show 15? I gotta say, I love that they have a Fire TV feature built into this. I can just go through there, pick the shows that I want. I can now watch Netflix and Prime Video, and we've even got ESPN and the NFL channel. So I'm excited for using this, but let me know in the comments below what you think. One thing that I really wish that I hope is a future update with this device right here is I hope they bring a better smart home dashboard to the device. They got a really cool dashboard if you have one of the Fire tablets, but I would like to see that dashboard come to the Echo Show 15. Anyway, wishful thinking, but I hope to see that in the future. If you guys enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. Let me know that you liked it. As always, don't forget to subscribe for more content like this, and I'll see you in the next video.